Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how to prove the Cauchy-Schwarz inequality for two vectors x and y in Rn. The inequality states that the absolute value of the dot product between x and y is less than or equal to the product of the magnitudes of x and y. First, I'm going to assume that x is not the zero vector, and y is not the zero vector. Since if either of them was the zero vector, then the inequality would hold true trivially, since both sides of the inequality would become zero. I'm going to define a third vector z to be equal to the unit vector in the x direction minus the unit vector in the y direction. And we know that the unit vector is simply the vector itself divided by its magnitude. And this vector is still in Rn. Now I'm going to take the dot product between z and itself. And it's equal to x hat minus y hat dot x hat minus y hat. Then I'm going to use the distributive property of the dot product to get that this is equal to x hat dot x hat. Then minus x hat dot y hat. Minus y hat dot x hat and lastly y hat dot y hat. Now we know that the dot product of a vector with itself is equal to its magnitude squared. So we get that z dot z is equal to the magnitude of z squared, which is equal to the magnitude of x hat squared. Then I'm going to use the commutative property of the dot product for vectors in Rn, which states that x hat dot y hat is equal to y hat dot x hat. So we get 2 times x hat dot y hat, and lastly the magnitude of y hat squared. Now the magnitude of a unit vector is 1, and 1 squared is still 1, so this is equal to 2 minus 2 times x hat dot y hat. And now since this is equal to the magnitude of the vector z squared, so this has to be non-negative, so greater than or equal to 0. Let's then divide by 2 and take x hat dot y hat to the right hand side, so that we're left with 1 is greater than or equal to x hat dot y hat. And x hat was x divided by its magnitude, and y hat y divided by its magnitude. And now, since the magnitudes of the vectors are scalars, we can take them in front of the dot product to get that this is equal to 1 over the magnitude of x times the magnitude of y times x dot y. Now we can multiply both sides by the magnitude of x times the magnitude of y, and since this is a non-negative quantity, the inequality sign doesn't flip, and we're left with the magnitude of x times the magnitude of y is greater than or equal to x dot y. And now x dot y could be positive or negative, but it's always less than or equal to its absolute value. And now since x dot y is less than or equal to the absolute value of x dot y, but x dot y is also less than or equal to the magnitude of x times the magnitude of y, it means that the absolute value of x dot y is less than or equal to the magnitude of x times the magnitude of y. Thus, we have proved the inequality we sought to prove.